So today what we are going to do, today we are going to see about system landscape. System landscape, yesterday we have completed architecture. So it is getting repeated in the material again. So we are not going to see architecture again. We are going to see about landscape, system landscape of SAP. So what is landscape? In general, it is arrangement of server. Arrangement of servers is called as system landscape. So in SAP, we will have three landscape environment. SAP environment will have three landscape, that is development server, production server and quality assurance server. So yesterday we have discussed about that architecture, right? Layers, presentation,
yes.
Application, yes. And database. In that, database and application will mainly integrated in this development server. Presentation system, we can able to place that presentation system in any location and it need to be get connected through internet to this database from different countries and from different branches likewise. So production server, for example, now you are in company, you are seeing the SAP screen right on your system.
Yes.
And you are posting entries, generating reports, right?
Yes.
That is production activity actually. For example, generally you will work on easy access screen, correct?
Yes, easy access.
On easy access. Whatever the activities that we are doing on easy access, it is production. Can you able to do any customizing and configuration in easy access?
No, I don't have access.
You don't have that access.
No, I don't have that access.
Yes. So that configuration and customizing, the changes, settings, whatever the things that we have to reconfigure or we have to customize, we have to do it in development. From development, workflow will happen from development to production, quality and then to production. Always workflow will not go from production to quality, quality to development, not in backward direction. Always the data flow and workflow will start in development, then quality and then production. In this order, not in backward order. So what is the main purpose of the development? For example, we are using Microsoft Windows, correct?
Yes.
That Windows operating system used to integrate your hardware and software, correct?
Yes.
That kind of work will happen on development. Development server will get connected to the database, networking, server system, internet, all those things will be get configured from development, and that development will work as a intermediator between your production system and your hardware. So for example, if you are searching a company code, that will be processed in development from your database. It will search for you on behalf of you, the development server. In the development server system, if it is configured properly, it will be get searched in database and it will be processed and it will be displayed in production system as output. So development, simple example, what we can say for development is it is like settings in mobile and laptop. For example, this is my desktop screen, right?
Yes.
This screen is like production system. If I need to open this PC, I can open from here. It will open. If I need to, for example, if I need to open Adobe Reader, it will open. But these are all configured and integrated with Windows operating system, right?
Yes.
In backend, it is already installed. These applications are installed. This file explorer, this file Windows Explorer is configured. When I open this, these things need to be happen. Likewise, it will be get configured. If I need to do any changes, for example, if I need to change this wallpaper, actually, for example, I need to right click, go to personalized setting, and I can change the background and I can change the wallpaper like this.
Yes.
Like this. I'll change like this. And I'll just, now a new wallpaper has been set. Now you can see this wallpaper is too big. It is not showing the exact content. It is too big. The picture size is stretched fully. So again, I need to go to settings and I need to customize that. So what I the customize I need to do, instead of fill, I need to make it as fit and I can close. Now it will be get fitted in my screen. So that this in production screen, I can able to see the output. For example, I'm just opening this PC and I'm going to D drive and I'm going to some folders, for example, movies, and I need to copy this movie from here. And to D drive means these things is a kind of customizing. I don't need this movie in this folder. I need to move it to my E drive. These are all called customizing. I need to change the environment or I need to change something new. Those things are settings. I don't need this color and I don't need some of the applications here. So I'll go to control panel and I can uninstall. So this kind of customizing and configurations will happen on development screen. The entire SAP is implemented in development and it is controlled by some support consultants. Based on the support consultants help, production will work. If you are having, for example, if you are having any issue in your company, you will raise a ticket, right? You can raise a ticket to support person. I'm not able to access the screen, or it is throwing some error. Likewise, if you raise, they will work on the system and they will give you a reply, it is rectified. Then you can able to work. Still, if you are having any issue, you can just again raise a ticket, still it is not working, so that you can escalate that issue, correct?
Yes.
So that kind of activities will happen on development. What is the role of quality? Actually, the role of quality here is, it will check the data which is getting transported and processed in development to production is correct or not. For example, if you are trying to search some company code, but that company code is not in the database, or you are selecting a company code, for example, for Poland HP, but you have done some small changes in currency. Instead of using, what is the currency you will use?
Polish zloty.
Instead of that, you can, for example, your company's global company USD currency, by mistakenly select, that means the system will throw error, right? Currency is inconsistent currency, or it will show you a warning message, currency is changed. That kind of quality check will be happen with the help of quality assurance server. Or if you are selecting some invalid files, if you are, for example, if you are having some third party tool and you are pulling some set of 1,000 or 2,000 invoices, if you are selecting a wrong file, the system will show invalid file format, right?
Yes.
So this kind of activities will be get controlled by quality assurance server. So apart from these three server, this three setup is happen in each and every client location. In client office, you will have this setup, but you will have one more server, which is called sandbox server. What is this sandbox server is, when we are starting an implementation project, at the initial stage in sandbox server, we will customize and configure that SAP application according to the client. We cannot able to give that application which we used for previous client or some other standard method, right? Each and every client will have a set of requirement. They don't use the standard. If they need to use the standard structure, means they won't come for SAP, right? If they are flexible with the features available in the system, available in the software, they won't come for SAP. They need customization. They need new configurations and customizing according to their business requirement. They are not willing to customize them. They are interested to customize the application according to their requirement. That's why they are doing implementation on SAP, this kind of huge applications. Why? Because they are doing business around the globe. They will have different requirements, different thoughts. So that kind of requirement and configuration which the client asked will be performed in sandbox, and testing, fine tuning, all those things will happen in sandbox. For example, before launching any operating system or anything, so they will give development preview, correct?
Yes.
Then beta update 1, beta update 2. So this procedure will happen some 1 month or 2 months or 3 months according to the software, and then only we will get the final standard version. Even if a company is trying to launch a car, immediately they won't launch. In Auto Expo or in any public, they will launch the concept and they will showcase that car. We are going to manufacture a car like this with these features. First, they will showcase. Based on the response from customers, based on the customer's thought, they will plan whether we can go for production or we can drop in this stage. And they can look for another model, what the clients need. Actually, for example, in big markets like India, US, China, most of the customers are interested on SUV. If you launch a van kind of vehicle, or if you launch a sedan kind of vehicles, there is no interest on customer, right? They need to understand the market actually, and then only they will plan for the product. So after that, clients and customers' feedback, they will generate a concept. Based on that concept, they will go for pre-production activities. In that pre-production activity, they will manufacture 1 or 2 or 3 cars, and they will check aerodynamic, all those things, and they will make changes to the panels, small design changes. After that, inside the company, if they get approval within the company, if they get approval, okay, proceed with this model, use this concept to production. Likewise, if they get approval from the management, then they will manufacture some 10 or 15 cars, and they will test that cars in different terrains and different conditions, climatic conditions, different terrains, and they will install lot of sensors, cameras, recording devices and computers, all those things, and they will drive more kilometers, more miles, and they will check the computers, how the engine is performing, how the gearbox is performing, all those things. Based on that feedback, they will fine-tune that car.